Welcome back to the Artie Lang Show. My next guest is a regular on the show, good friend of the show. Got a bunch of things to talk to him about. The world of sports is nonstop craziness these days. From Sports Illustrated, please welcome Chris Mannix. What's up, Chris?
You big into this figure skating we're watching up here?
Yeah, figure skating is up there.
I figured that's an Artie Lang.
We're trying to support the Olympics. What do you think about the Olympics? And like to me, this Putin guy is the closest thing we've had to like Hitler's Olympics. it really is weird watching him up there.
I don't think it's been as embarrassing as it seemed like it was going to be. It was really embarrassing in the buildup.
It looked like some major embarrassing that was going to happen on the world stage, like nuttiness.
There were people. I mean, there were quotes from I think it was a mayor of one of the nearby towns that said, the gay people need to stay away from the kids. when does gay all of a sudden become pedophiles?
No, that's just
there are plenty of straight people that are pedophiles.
That's just the tip of the iceberg with this.
Yeah,
with the homophobia over there.
It's insane.
They weren't going to allow. Like, there's some law where they weren't going to allow children that were from. Orphans that were from countries where same-sex marriage was legal to get adopted.
Yeah.
Like literally that connection was enough.
Yeah.
So that's out of control. So that's one part. But what else were you going to say?
No, just the whole thing. I mean, the whole thing is a train wreck. But I do think that now that it's started, you're hearing less and less of it. There was that story about the Dutch speed skater that's gay.
Yeah.
And she went up to Putin at a party and gave him a big hug. And and she said they cuddled. That was her quote, that he and Putin would cuddle.
Yeah,
but it's kind of funny. Like, it seems like, as embarrassing as it was, it seemed like it was going to be in the buildup, it seems to have gone seamlessly so far, including the other stuff, the security.
Yeah.
Even, the weather's been kind of weirdly warm out there. But everything seems to be going pretty fluidly.
Well, thank God for that, because the security part.
Yeah.
Because there were some real scary. But here's the thing. Since 9/11, we're going to get this. And now, especially since the Boston Marathon and stuff more recent, every major event, I think, sports or otherwise, we're going to hear about security issues. The Super Bowl took a long time to get in and out of, man. It's a shame, but what else are you going to do?
There's always going to be radicals that go out there and say, this is where we're going to be our coming out party. But, if you do things right.
That's what I mean. But how do you not take that serious to
you
where...
You have to take it seriously.
Yeah, that's what I mean. You have to take it seriously to where you go the extra mile, to where it really becomes an inconvenience. Like, this last Super Bowl was really discouraging to go to another one. I mean, the fact that it sucked is one thing. But, the weather was great. And, the event itself, whatever, was It was an awful game. But that being said, it should have been way more, joyful than it was.
Yeah.
There was a feeling of tension.
I can't get into watching. Like, last night, I've been writing all week long. I had the night off last night. I went to the bar. And the only time I can get into the Olympics is if I'm drinking. That's it. Like, because all of a sudden, you're watching curling, and it's like, all right, USA, USA. You start the chant at the bar.
Curling on any level. Exactly.
Curling's fun to watch.
Curling was on. Like, downhill skiing was on. Like, ordinarily, I could not possibly give a crap about any of this stuff.
Yeah.
But it's on. You start getting that,
all right. This guy. This guy's skating around. I can't see. As a sober person, I can't watch that.
Yeah.
I like to watch the figure skating for the falls only.
There was a guy last night that took a bad digger.
I'm rooting for bad falls.
No, see, this says something about him. He told me this the other day. He only roots for them to fall because their dreams are broken. That's an exact quote from you.
Yeah. Well, it makes it more exciting. The falling is funny, first of all. And then, all that additional emotional...
But if a bunch of figure skaters were lined up when you announced your retirement after 7 years, knowing you wanted 10 years, if a bunch of figure skaters lined up laughing at you, wouldn't that have made you mad?
Sure. But it would have justified my watching them fall.
But that didn't happen. So your anger is
You're right.
Right about one thing, though. Like, when these guys, they work for 4 years to get to this moment, if you take a tumble in your first event.
Yeah, you talk
all
pressure.
Out the window.
That's what makes it so interesting, because then you examine their emotional reaction to that fall, and it's just fascinating.
I'm curious.
You're right. I mean, it's human emotion.
I'm curious about one thing, and this I had a thought about writing a story about this 4 years from now. If you spent the next 4 years training to be a curler, could you do it?
Yeah.
Could you compete for an Olympic spot?
Well, it depends on what part. Is it the one that throws it?
I guess you have to rotate. Each one does one part. Basically, curling to me is a combination of shuffleboard and darts.
Well, what's the hardest part is when you do the sweeping, right?
Yeah, but don't you do that in shuffleboard, though, too? Like, you got to time it to get into a
slot. But, I mean, is there a speed thing with that? Listen, Just looking at it, you're right. I think I could, in over a weekend, I could pretty much learn how to do it.
Yeah.
But I think that about, what about the, like, the luge? Don't you just sit in the thing?
That's tougher, though. I feel like you have to use your body weight to twist and turn. I mean, it's all, like, fractions of a second, too.
Yeah. Well, okay. All right. Maybe you're right there. I don't know exactly.
Luge is funny, too. The two-man luge.
Yeah.
I love that.
The Winter Olympics.
It's like, why?
The Winter Olympics.
You're the guy on the bottom. Yeah. Why? What are you there for?
Well, the U.S. couldn't win. What was the half pipe competition? They couldn't come in first. That's basically a sport we invented.
Yeah.
And they can't win.
Explain the half pipe. What is that?
It's the one that Sean White was participating
in. Okay, well, what is it?
It's basically, I'm trying to describe it. It's
a half a pipe.
Yeah, it's half. It's built like
it's a half. People watching. Look, here's the pipe.
Yeah.
You take the top off, and it's a half a pipe.
Okay,
and that's snow.
And they go back and forth. It's like when
and then they just like throw them down a hill.
No, they're going up and down like this, sort of.
Oh, they're skating.
Yeah. Well, no,
they're
boards,
on a snowboard.
Oh, snowboarding.
Like
oh,
skateboarding.
That's a skill.
It's what the skateboarders do. There.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, that's a real skill.
Oh, that's definitely a real skill.
I'm talking about. It seems the other thing. You're just laying in that thing. You know.
Yeah, the skeleton going face first. That scares the crap out of me. I would never do that. They go like 75 miles an hour face first down those things.
What is it?
It's basically the luge, but you're going face first. It's called skeleton. I mean, isn't that exactly what it is? It's the luge,
it's
but
sledding.
Face first.
It's sledding.
Yes.
Sledding.
I would like to do it for pure enjoyment, but I would not try to go 75 miles per hour. And why I think that's a tougher thing to learn, because I'm watching last night, it was on, and it is. It's like one tenth of a second determines like first and eighth place. Yeah. Like that's it. So there is a art to using your body.
One tenth of a second, first and eighth place. That is disappointing.
Wouldn't it, if you were heavier, wouldn't your mass help you? Like if you were 400 pounds and you were doing the skeleton, wouldn't you be the best in the world? Like if you were able to control your body properly?
I interviewed Curtis Tomasevich, who's on the bobsledding team, and I'm guessing it's the same sort of aerodynamics.
Gravity.
He said that the best bobsledders are fat and fast.
Yeah.
Like basically, so you can get
speed going. Morbidly, I've said this before about hockey goalies. Just get a 600-pound guy.
Yeah.
And stuff him in the net.
Right.
Stuff him
some
in
some sumo
there.
Wrestler. Put him. Plug him in.
Just literally, just kick. Stuff them in there. Wow. Grease them up and, like, you know, if you can move just a little bit.
I feel like I could have a future in bobsledding or luging.
You should. You should try to compete for one of the Olympic sports in 2018.
Well, you're not nearly that heavy.
I'm heavy. I'm 260.
Well, Curtis,
I'm
Curtis
about
Tomasevich,
a 500-pound guy.
Curtis Tomasevich, who is the reigning four-man bobsled team. He won in 2010. He's won three world championships. He played football at Nebraska. He was on the 01 team that played Miami in the Orange Bowl that lost.
Right.
So there's some football background, at least in one of these guys, who's apparently elite at this particular sport.
Yeah, but I'm talking about like a 500 or 600-pound guy, just like really disgusting.
I think that might be
that
you
would
might
be
slow
incredible,
down
though. Yeah, well, you're right. There's a point of limiting returns when you're – flab is hanging over the sides and dragging on the ice and slowing you
I'm
down.
I'm noticing Buscetti's not here, also I would suggest he would be the one. We could put him on the...
He'd never show up, though. It's a problem.
Yeah.
Right. He's got a... He has a possible goiter, we found out. Now, what do you know about goiters? John diagnosed this. And can we show him the video?
Gout and goiter.
Show the video of him, of Mike coughing. The other day, it's extraordinary.
Yeah.
And one of the things with a goiter is your second chin becomes enormous.
Well, it's your
fleshy growth.
What gland? Your
thyroid.
Thyroid. There you go. My gosh, what can I think of that?
Fleshy growth.
Your thyroid gets so enlarged.
I'm sick.
Yeah.
Last time I was here, we were showing Buscetti haircut pictures. There's too many videos of him out there.
Where do you see the goiter?
Far too many videos.
Where do you see the goiter thing where he's trying to like?
I think we were just looking at goiters on the iPad.
No. I'm talking about when he's coughing and his chin goes.
Oh.
And he pulls his face in.
Oh, it looks where he almost vomited.
Oh.
Yeah, he almost pukes. He does. Yeah, there you go. Right, right. Watch.
That's a.
It's hard to see it with that camera.
You got to play through the pain. If he's got a goiter, you got to show up.
Watch.
God, I hope that video's on your website. You got to tweet that video, too.
I'm going through the same thing. Sick.
Well, that's. I think maybe that's a chalking fitzix.
That's what he's talking
about. That's what he said he has. That's a chalking fitzix right there.
Look at how his chin, his second chin fans out. Like,
look.
It's like someone from X-Men. Like the chin becomes a weapon.
Do you know the germs he's spreading probably in his living area?
No, I'm not going anywhere near that side of the room.
Not even that. You're right. Our kitchen, our gourmet kitchen by DirecTV. I'm talking about the attic that he lives in 18 hours a day. He needs to be in the phone booth.
This is why he said he's not in today.
Choking fitzix?
No, chalking.
Chalking. Gotcha.
Chalking. Well, it could be choking.
Well, C-H-O-C-K-I-N-G.
Chalking fitzix?
Chalking. What? I think that's a chalking fitzix.
That's what he's going through. Well, we put that next to him trying to sneeze, too, and that was great. We had both side by side.
Oh, my God.
And we'll show that later.
Ole Miss football's proud right there. They have that.
Ole Miss, someone on Twitter gave it to him. I said, where'd you get that? Someone on Twitter gave it to me.
One of his fans?
Mm-hmm. That's some of his followers.
Yeah.
Do you know on Twitter, he has 8,231 followers, and he follows 9,300.
Yeah. It should never be that kind of dynamic. You should never follow more people, because virtually everyone you do follow in that circumstance will follow you back.
Well, that's what I mean. Especially if you're an entertainer for a living, that doesn't look good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like 1,000 less people want to know what you're doing than you want to know what they're doing.
How does one follow that many people? Like, your timeline must just be blown up.
Oh. Mike is following companies like Land Rover and things like that.
Do we have a list?
You got to get an intern or somebody like that to go through the list and pick the top 10 best flaws of Mike Boschetti.
Well, just make a list of the followers in general.
There's got to be at least 4 porn stars on there.
Completely indiscriminate following. Hey, we can't see it with the...
Can you move the jib? Thank you. Thank you. Oh, yeah, here's the... You've seen the sneeze.
I've seen the sneeze, yeah.
And then it goes away.
And it went away.
I think the chalking fitzix is better
than the sneeze. There's something about the sneeze that is so extraordinary to me. There's something about the sneeze that is so non-like anything else I've seen by a human. Like, I've seen somebody cough before, but he seems like an enormous, obese baby bird.
Can you imagine if he went through with that? That would be a saliva tsunami.
I'm out sick.
Think about what would have come out of his mouth.
I don't know. If he had sneezed that.
Oh. Like, projectile. 3-day-old lunch would be coming out of there.
Get some lunch. Oh, that's right. Like X-Men type stuff.
Just nasty.
Look. Where is that going? Yeah. What the hell is going on?
The body's very forgiving.
Hey, the last time Mike was out, we tried to get in touch with him during the show, and he ignored us for three hours.
He's not going to come up.
He ignores us. That's the thing. Well, that's what I want to bring out.
Well,
I want to
bring
attention to that. He's sick, but he's tweeting the whole time,
You can tweet when you're sick.
Well, then he can see that we're trying to text him and talk to him.
Well, maybe he doesn't want to talk because he's sick.
Does the goiter mess with your vocal cords?
I guess it looks like it does.
It looks like it does.
Messes with a lot of stuff.
Maybe. It messes with your sex life, your everything.
Yeah.
Did you show him any of the goiter? Look at the you got to.
You've seen goiters before, right?
Yes, unfortunately.
I don't get exactly what a goiter is. It's like a little stone in your throat that swells it up.
Your thyroid becomes enlarged because your body's lacking iodine.
Who even knew your body needed iodine? How does 99% of the world get the right amount of iodine and these people don't?
That's
salt.
Aren't you supposed to take iodine if, like, a nuclear weapon goes off or something? I don't know.
Is that true?
That's what I read somewhere.
But didn't Morton put it in salt, and that's why we started not getting goiters anymore?
Is that why? I mean, even before then, most of the world did not get goiters.
Most of the world got iodine in some form,
How did they get it, and the people who got goiters didn't get it, is my point. Like, how did that happen? In the same family.
I think the people who were getting goiter were people in third world countries who just had a very limited diet where they never had anything beyond a certain
food. But people in their family weren't getting
goiter. Well, they're eating like dirt and rocks.
Well, what was your brother having? Filet mignon?
Yeah, I mean, if you were eating
what
just
does one
normal
have
foods,
with dirt and rocks?
You have pica if you're eating dirt and rocks.
You can't get a nice, like, saffron fusion salad with that?
I'm going to say, I'm going to look up foods with iodine.
Oh, no, God.
We're going to take a break. We have a lot of questions. You know, the All-Star game. Are you going to the All-Star game?
No, thank
no?
God.
You don't want to go?
I've been the last, I think, 7 years.
Is that a bad event?
It's not a bad event, but when you travel as much as I tend to travel.
I hear you, man. From stand-up, I travel, you know, you get like a lot of things. That's why the Super Bowl this year was great in the sense that I didn't have to get on a plane.
Yeah.
But
I did New Orleans about 5 years ago. I did the All-Star game down there. Wound up on Bourbon Street. I was much younger then. I was on Bourbon Street on a Friday night. I was barely able to make the game on Sunday after that.
First time I was ever in New Orleans, I was 19 years old. And when you're doing Bourbon Street at 19 is very different than when you're 46.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. Lake Pontchartrain. Yeah, that was you're right. You will drink until, like, some physical thing in you makes you vomit.
And those I was doing those hurricanes all night with a buddy of mine who's got a wooden leg. It's ridiculous
at
how
Pat
much
O'Brien's,
he goes. Pat O'Brien's, yes. And it's not just the alcohol content in those. The sugar kills you.
Right, it's all fruit punch and booze.
Oh, God, it gives you. That was one of the mothers of all hangovers.
That is. That's a bad one. Bad headaches, and it's expensive, too. When I was 19, we had nothing. I can remember the three of us spent like $100 each, and we couldn't believe how much we spent. But
they offer them in these yard glasses, too. There are people ordering that stuff. It's like, are you kidding me?
This big.
You're going to die. Yeah. You're going to be on the street dead in a couple hours. You do two of them, and it's over.
Right, so you're not going to go to that.
No.
I want to ask you about Carmelo. What real quick, Carmelo Anthony, what's going to happen with this?
He stays. He's not going anywhere.
He'll stay as a Knick.
As a Knick.
Yeah. He said he'll stay and take a discount.
Yeah.
But, okay, so what responsibility do the Knicks have at that point? Who do they got to go get? Like, what's an example of a guy they got to get?
In order for, and we'll talk about this, I'm sure, later on, but in order for Carmelo to succeed, he has to have a strong point guard. It's got to be a point guard.
So Irving type guy.
He needs Kyrie Irving. Yeah, but that would mean he has to go to Cleveland because Kyrie Irving is not going anywhere right now.
Because he's not leaving.
No, he's not. He can't. He's under contract, and those second-year rookie deals are tough to get out of.
What about Rondo?
You know, it's one of those pipe dreams that the New York, the Knicks keep putting out there. But Rondo's under contract next year with the Celtics.
He's going to stay with Boston.
He's staying with Boston. So, and basically, Knicks fans, to summarize, there's no hope.
Yeah. All right.
Hey,
on that.
Concentrated food sources of iodine, including sea vegetables, yogurt, cow's milk, eggs, strawberries, mozzarella cheese, fish, and shellfish.
What? Mozzarella cheese what?
Rich in iodine.
So you got to eat
all those
foods. You got to eat mozzarella salad and you'll be all right?
Yeah.
Eat mozzarella, don't get good.
Or eat fish and shellfish.
There's one thing the Artie Lang show can tell you.
Eggs.
This is one to grow on the Artie Lang show. Have some mozzarella, avoid goiters.
Yes.
If you've seen a goiter, nothing is less attractive to a woman.
Right.
I can't see a guy with a goiter.
Well, that's
been
we're seeing that demonstrated by Mike's.
What's a goiter on Mike equal then? If it's
it's
well, that's what he has. Right. That's what's turning all
if
the ladies
George,
off.
If George Clooney had a bad goiter, he would not get laid. Okay, so just let me put it to you that way. All right. if David Beckham had a goiter, he'd lose every broad he's banging on the side.
Yeah.
Assuming he is. If that guy had a goiter on the figure skating, was that Brian Boitano?
No, Scott Hamilton, right?
If Scott Hamilton had a goiter, he'd lose every girl in his life.
The Artie Lang Show, weeknights on Audience, only on DirecTV.